called The American Dream. But before I go into that, I want to read this quote. I'm not going to lie to you guys. I'm going to read it because there was no way I was going to remember this. But it was by a freelance writer named James Trudeau. He was actually the one that coined the phrase The American Dream and what it actually stood for. So he said, "But there has been also the American Dream, that dream of a land in which life should be better and richer and fuller for every man, with opportunity for each according to his ability or achievement. It is a difficult dream for the European upper classes to interpret adequately. And to many of us, ourselves have grown weary and mistrustful of it. It is not a dream of motor cars and highways merely, but a dream of social order in which each man and each woman shall be able to attain to the fullest stature of which they are innately capable, and be recognized by others for what they are, regardless of the fortuitous, that's a really difficult word to say, people, circumstances of birth or position. The American dream that has lured tens of millions of all nations to our shores in the past century has not been a dream of merely maternal plenty, though it has doubtlessly been counted heaven. It has been much more than man and woman, unhampered by the barriers which had slowly been erected in the older civilizations, unrepressed by social orders which had developed for the benefit of classes rather than for simple human beings of any and every class." Now, why am I reading that? Because I think this is the perfect example of what the American Dream really is, and something that we forget. And when I think of the American Dream, it's resonates with my grandfather, and I'm going to tell you his story and exactly why he lived and is currently still living the American Dream. He was born in a humble town of Santa Cruz del Norte in Cuba. He tells a story of having to walk miles to get to school. He actually had to drop out of school at the age of 10 because he had to help his father. There wasn't enough money to pay the bills, there wasn't enough money to get food. So instead of continuing his education and being able to do the things that we take for granted as Americans, he had to go and help the family. And he had to do things that we would never even think about doing. In this day and age, we would never think about telling our kid, a 10-year-old, "Hey, don't worry about school, go work." And he has vivid memories of going and playing in the bay, and everything that he says is positive about it, which is something that to me is crazy when I'm getting pulled out of school at 10 years old to go work. This is actually, for anybody that knows, this is the Hershey plant in Cuba. Hershey was one of the predominant companies that was in Cuba at the time. They provided chocolate and had cocoa plants there. My great-grandfather used to work at this train station right here. He actually not only helped unload, but his job was to find and make sure everyone had a ticket to get on the train itself. My grandfather has vivid memories of having to go over there and help my great-grandfather help his dad with people that weren't supposed to be there. He says he's a tough guy, I don't believe it, but, you know. And also he had to help unload, and till this day, has back pains, and he also has arthritis issues. He thinks it's from that. I just think he's being dramatic personally. And I put this here because this is one of the jobs that he still remembers having as a 10-year-old. He said that he would actually get a little bicycle cart just like this, fill it up with fruit, and that's actually how he helped provide for the family. He would sell that. If it wasn't fruit, he would bring the newspaper, if it wasn't the newspaper. He actually said that as a 10-year-old, he would be transporting alcohol. He said anything and everything to be able to provide. I also put this on here because he said, again, my grandfather, sometimes I think he over-exaggerates. He said that he would ride his bike 10 miles to go see my grandmother because his older brother, who was the only one that had a car, would not drive him at the time. So he had to ride all the way over there. He said that that was the sign of true love, I think it's the sign of great cat on this display. And then came the revolution and the Castro regime. My grandfather was against it at the time. He actually fought in the Bay of Pigs. He tells stories of him actually waiting for the American government to come help and being in the woods. And then the Castro regime coming and him just hearing bullets fly through the trees and having to run. He actually tells a story that the biggest guy in the whole troop was getting ready. He was like, I'm gonna get them. I'm ready. I'm the biggest, baddest dude here. I got this. You guys get behind me. And he said when those bullets started flying, the guy threw his gun down and just took off and running. But my grandfather for a long time held a lot of ill will because of what happened here. He felt that he was kind of left to dry. But at the end of the day, he says that it was a step that led him to where he's at now. Unfortunately, after that, he was actually put in prison. He spent 1 year in Cuban prison. I've actually done walkthroughs of American prisons, and those are pretty rough, so I can only imagine what a Cuban prison is like. He tells stories of not being able to eat every day, that sometimes they wouldn't give him food. Sometimes they would come in and just beat him because he was against the regime, and obviously the regime was the ones in charge of the prison. Till this day, in that prison, while he was there, he had to actually make a purse. It was made out of wood and bamboo, and he still has it, and he gave it to my mother. And he says it's to remember all the sacrifices and the hard times, and that we could always push forward and move on, and that there's always light at the end. And it, to him, it's his most prized possession, and he would never lose that. And he asked my mom to actually put it in a safe so we could continue to have it throughout the generations. But luckily, he was able to make it out of prison, or else I wouldn't be here, obviously. But he was able to make it out of prison, and he was able to come to the United States. He actually had one failed attempt at first. He was stopped by the Cuban Coast Guard, or the Cuban Navy. And again, he was beaten, but at least he was not taken to prison. He was just roughed up a little bit, he says, and he just waited. And luckily, he was given an opportunity to take a plane. He said opportunity that he thought would never come. But it was because my grandmother's family was part of the military. And luckily, he was able to get that plane ticket and purchase it. He took a risk that I would never be able to do. He actually left Cuba with a one-year-old, with absolutely nothing but a suitcase, and came to New York. And there, he was able to prosper. When he came in, he said that his brother gave him $100 and told him, this is the only thing I'm gonna give you. He turned that $100, started working as a handyman in a building, and then opened his own laundromat. From there, he moved down to Hialeah, where he actually made his roots and where we stayed. He was able to then become a grandfather. That's actually me. And those are my two brothers. When I was born, he told my grandmother, stop working. What your job is now is to take care of our grandkids. And he worked two jobs to be able to provide and to help. He sacrificed everything to really be able to live life so that we could have it. And those sacrifices have borne fruit. My mother is VP of Danaher for Human Resources. All of his grandkids were able to graduate from the university. I only did FIU, the other two might have done better universities, but neither here nor there. I'm a director of training for Canyon. My middle brother, my younger brother, is an attorney, and the youngest was actually just accepted into med school. So that's what the American dream is, and that's what it showed. And my grandfather, to this day, is able to say that his sacrifices were fair. So, thank you guys very much.